Hello friends, welcome to GT Science tutorial. In this video, I am going to explain about Freundlich adsorption isotherm. Freundlich was the first man who tried to explain the adsorption isotherm curve on the basis of some mathematical form. So what actually is Freundlich adsorption isotherm and what is that formula? Let's see that. Freundlich proposed the empirical formula for only type 1 adsorption isotherm curve. If you want to know about other adsorption isotherm curve as well, then you can check in the description below because I have already made a video on adsorption isotherm curve. Okay, so the first type adsorption isotherm curve looks like this, right? And here this is x by m. X by m means extent of adsorption, that is amount of gas adsorbed on the surface of adsorbent when the mass of that adsorbent is 1 gram, and here this p is the pressure. So this is what type 1 adsorption isotherm curve looks like. And let us make 2 points over here. Okay, now what Freundlich actually did was Freundlich proposed an empirical formula to explain type 1 adsorption isotherm curve. Okay, by the way, this is the first attempt to explain any adsorption isotherm by any mathematical rule. So that's why Freundlich adsorption isotherm is very important topic as well. Okay, that formula he gave was y equals to kp to the power 1 by n. Okay, this is that formula he gave. There is no mathematical derivation for this formula. This is the limitation of Freundlich adsorption isotherm. Okay, because Freundlich just gave this formula and said this curve can be explained by using this formula, and he did not give any mathematical derivation, or he did not consider any theoretical considerations as well. Okay, so this is the you can say the limitation of Freundlich adsorption isotherm. Here this k is the constant, okay, and n equals to 1, 2, 3 dot, okay, these are the natural numbers, and this y is the extent of adsorption, and this p is the what? Pressure. Okay, now what he actually said, that when, let me write here, okay, from here to here, when n by 1 equals to 1, then in that condition what do we get? We get y equals to kp, and if we remove k, we get y directly proportional to p. Okay, if we remove k, then we get y directly proportional to p, that is extent of adsorption is directly proportional to the pressure. This shows that from here to here, from this point to this point, the curve shows the phenomenon in which the extent of adsorption is directly proportional to the pressure. Okay, so if we talk about the value of 1 by n to be 1, then we get this much curve only. Okay, now we consider another case. Let me erase this part so that we can write. He consider another case in which he put 1 by n equals to 0. So if we put 1 by n equals to 0, then what do we get? Then we get y equals to kp to the power 0, and we get k y equals to k. That means the value of y is constant now. That is, the value of extent of adsorption is constant now. That means if we put the value of 1 by n to be 0, then the extent of adsorption does not depend on pressure. So this point describes the curve of this region, okay, because this region's curve does not depend on pressure, okay, so does not depend on pressure. Now there is one more possibility, that is for 1 by n equals to 1 to 0. So if you put the value of 1 by n to be in the middle of 1 to 0, then we get this curve, okay, then we get remaining curve. So this is for what? 1 by n equals to 1, from here to here this is 1 by n equals to 0, and from here to here 1 by n equals to 1 to 0, okay, 1 to 0. So this is the formula that Freundlich actually gave. Now according to mathematics, let me erase this part. According to mathematics, what we can actually do, let's take log on both the sides, and we will get log y equals to log k plus 1 by n log p. So we can use this formula to do different numerical problems as well. So this is all about Freundlich adsorption isotherm. Freundlich adsorption isotherm is very important because this is the first attempt to explain the adsorption isotherm by using a formula, and it has certain limitation because it does not have any mathematical derivation. Where did this formula came from? Nobody knows. Okay, how did Freundlich write this formula? Nobody knows, because there is no mathematical consideration as well as there is no theoretical consideration as well. Okay, so these are the limitation of Freundlich adsorption isotherm, but still it is important because this is the first attempt to explain the adsorption isotherm. So that's all in this video. If you like the video, please share this video as much as you can, and thank you for watching the video.